Hi everyone, let's take a minute to look at masks and how to get a feathered edge on them. We're going to look at a layer mask, and then we're going to look at the selected mask tool. And we're not going to go into too much depth because we do that in other videos. But because students often have challenges trying to get that feather at the edge of a mask, I want to go through that in sort of an overview manner in regards to using the brush tool with your mask. I have this image of flowers and a butterfly, and what I'm looking at is this flower in the background that has a slight feather to it. So if I come over and I open my layers and I choose the flower layer, and I'm going to choose the quick select tool, the quick selection tool, select this flower. If I mask that, it's a hard edge. You can see I have a green background here behind the flower. So I'm going to undo that because that's not going to look very good. Okay, so there's a couple of different things I can do. First of all, with this flower selected, I can choose select and mask. There's my green background. And then I've got some properties in here that I can play with to try to get a little bit of a feather. First of all, at the very top, the transparency. If I slide that down to zero, I don't show the background at all. The mask is not being applied. What I want to work with in regards to a feather though, to get that nice soft edge, is this property down here about in the middle that says feather. And if I move that from right to left, you can see the edges of the flower change. And that's okay, it's a little better. Let's say we had to cut this flower out and put it on a different background. It's a little bit better to have the flower with a little bit of a feathered edge than none at all. However, there's some other things that we can do to help this. And let's look at another method. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply the mask. Instead of doing the selected mask, I'm just gonna go ahead and choose the layer mask. And with the mask selected, and you have to be careful because if you have clicked on the left thumbnail in this layers panel, it's going to select the flower image itself. You want to make sure that you click on the mask to select it. Now I'm going to come over and find my brush tool. And I want to come up and look at the size of it and the hardness. Now, remember, you have the brackets on your keyboard that are going to make it larger and smaller and more feather and less of a feather. I'm going to go ahead and choose this up here, though, so that you can see what I'm doing. Choose this, choose the properties up here at the top of the Photoshop interface. So on the brush tool, so we can make it really obvious, maybe I'll make it around 80, 79. Hardness, I'll just put around 50%. And with my mask selected, if I come in, I want you to notice what's happening. Part of my mask is being removed, and that's because my paint chip is set to white. Remember, white reveals and black hides. Black conceals. So if I want to actually get rid of that, I'm going to switch it over to my black. I'm going to zoom in so you can see the edges a little bit more. You can see a little bit of a feather going on in here. So the idea is that I want to get more of a feather, a soft edge around here so that it looks more natural. And if I go smaller on my brush by clicking my left bracket, I can get in there a little closer without it looking too funky. Now I'm not doing a great job. And if I was doing this for a project professionally, I would spend a lot more time on it. But you can see I'm starting to get a little bit better edge here that looks more natural. And let's say I go in way too much. Oops. Go back, choose the white chip, and start coming out a little bit more. Now, if I come up and I choose a hardness of 0, you can see how that edge is getting even softer. So we've got pixels over here that have 100% opacity, and over here that have 100% transparency. And we have basically a gradient in between. The feather is going to allow you to choose how much of a gradient that is. If this is a hard-edged object like a building, then you wouldn't have a feather. You would have a hard edge. However, if it's going to be a soft edge, in this example, a flower in the background, then you're going to have a much softer edge. And get rid of my mask. My brush and the feather that I'm going to use for this background flower is going to be very different than the edge that I would choose for this butterfly or this flower in the foreground. What's really cool is we can combine the two. Select my flower. Choose select and mask. Feather the edge a little bit, not too much. Come down to the bottom of the properties panel and choose output to layer mask. Click OK. And now it's a layer mask. If I click on the layer mask in the layers panel and then choose the brush tool, I can go in and I can refine that edge. And at the edge of this flower, you see where this is a little bit dark? We really wouldn't want that. It wouldn't be outlined. Whatever the background is going to be would simply show through the edges. Now, you have to work a little bit to finesse this. This is going to be too much, the feather that I have right there. I've come into the flower too far. But if I switch over to white, and I make my brush a little bit smaller, I can start finessing that so that it looks really good. And it just takes a little bit of time. So there you go. With a little bit of practice, you can make great feathered edges on your masks.